Greetings, everyone. Archimedes here, and welcome back to another brick-filled LEGO video. Today, we're going to be talking about ways to improve bionicle weapons. As a young builder, I had very few bionicle weapons, only this and this piece. So, in order to build robots in Mecha, I had to find some way of improving them so each robot could have a specialized weapon. The whole idea began when I was building the Angelus. I built the robot, and I was fairly happy with it, but I knew that it needed a sword, a weapon, and so I gave it this piece. But I found that it just was rather simple. It didn't have enough depth that the rest of the Angelus had. And so, as I was staring at the piece, I noted the holes. I already knew that you could stick studs backwards into these holes, and you could suspend some things from them. And so, I decided, on a whim, to attach some plates to add a spear, and it turned into this. As you can see, I used the spear running along the side, just some basic greebling bits, and suddenly, the Angelus had a personalized weapon. I then attached it to a quick hilt design, and was complete. For our video today, we're going to be taking a look at a couple concepts, a couple springboards I made for you, so that they might inspire you to use this to improve your robots in Mecha. We already took a look at the Angelus' sword, but now I'm just going to show you another quick concept I made for you this morning. This one uses a chainsaw base. Then what I did was I took a reverse angle slope plate, as you can see here, and I put on some fins, and I added some chainsaws on using clip pieces. I then attached that to the front, to these studs here, these holes here, shifted the chainsaws around, and voila, I had a sword. I then quickly created a little base, a little hilt for the sword, like this. Here is another, more complicated concept that I made. As you can see, it has some flamethrowers, some spears designed just like the Angelus. We'll take this off. As you can see, I used a rocket as a base with a plate to attach on some greebling details, and then fastened it on, once again, to the stud holes like this. I then designed a quick hilt using one of these three-way Technic cross pin stabby things, I don't know what to call it, and then attaching on these bionicle eyepieces. Flip that onto the back of our previous subassembly, and voila! We had a more chainsaw-y, fiery sword. But what I'm truly trying to get across with these springboards is merely an idea. That idea is that you can use these stud holes to improve your robots. You can expand some greebling over the top here, and it can really specialize and customize your designs, and give them a little more meaning or depth. Another way to customize your robot's weapons is to use Technic pieces. As you can see in this little subassembly here, we have a sword based off of two Technic spool pieces. We have a fire piece here, and then I've just added some tubes around here to add some extra greebled character. In our video today, we talked about ways to disguise or improve our Technic bionicle weapons. We take a look at a way that uses studs and the stud holes inside a Technic piece, or using a purely Technic design like this. Once again, let me make this point very clear. These concepts were merely designed as springboards, little ideas to help you move on in your building. They may not be that fancy as they are, but if you put your intellect to them, you might be able to come up with something absolutely spectacular. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this short video. I hope that it was interesting or informative, or at least that it entertained you for a minute or two, maybe? Well, my name is Archimedes36. And I'll see you next Sunday. A quick note on terminology. Greebling means to use small tiddly pieces to add grand mechanical details in models. For example, the small details on the sword, like this. In my own creation spotlight of the Angelus, I mentioned another builder named Starblaster 36, I believe. That builder now is on the Brickopedia galleries under the username Elyrkian J. You should check out his models.